Com. I am Anuja. In this video, I am going to explain you about the post processors which can be used for JMeter scripting. In JMeter scripting, many times we need the use of post processor to extract some authentication token or extract some response so we can add our response assertions, or to run our further test, we need a response from the earlier API or something like that. So in this case, we need to extract some value and assign it to a variable from our responses we get. There can be different types of response. It can be plain text, it can be JSON, or it can be a HTML response. But in this video, we are going to see different types of post processor with simple examples. So let's get started with this. In this, you can see a thread group where I have added a dummy sampler. In that, the response is in the form of HTML, you can see here. And we want to extract the response for this particular tag, name tag, and we want to extract this particular response. So to do so, we can add a regular expression extractor. We can add a meta type as a name. We need to extract its content as well. Once we have the content, you can see here, once we have the content, but there is multiple tags with this particular thing name, and I want to fetch the first one. So in the extraction, I'll be adding the number one, and match number will be one. First number that matches, you can extract that. So this is how I configured this one. Now let's run and find out how it works. Okay, in debug sampler we have added here to check the response regex variable. We are getting it as a viewport. Okay, now next move on to our next regular extractor which we are going to learn in this video is a JSON extractor. I'm uncommenting this. Okay. So here you can just click on add post processor and JSON path extractor. JSON extractor. We are using JSON extractor here. Okay. So check here in this dummy sample, this is the response which we will get. In the employees, we'll get first name Anuja, last name Jain, and we will be extracting Anuja here. So now let's run, let's clear this one and run the second one. See, this is the response you're getting, and what you're getting in your JSON variable is this one. So here you have named it as a JSON variable. If you don't get any proper response, then the default value that is not found will be shown. So if I mistype it and if I run it again, I'll get it as a not found. So you can add a default value as well to identify if there is an issue with your JSON extractor. Okay, so next we will learn about boundary extractor. Okay, you can go here, add from post processor boundary extractor. So we can specify the boundary from which we want to extract. So see, for this particular dummy sample, this is the response. Okay, this is the response data, but what we want to extract here as a only John, we want to extract this particular value and we want to assign it to a variable. So variable name we can give as a boundary variable, and simply we can copy this part, that is the left part of the boundary, left boundary, and this one, that is the left part, right part of the boundary, and then whatever will be inside within the boundary values which we give, that will be extracted. Okay, so to see this result, let's run this one. Okay, so we gave this as our left boundary, this as our right boundary value, and that's why we will get here in our variable the exact value which we want. So these are three types of extractors which we have seen in this video, which you can use it in your test to extract values. Then on the basis of the values, you can write your assertions. You can use this to fetch your authentication token and you know, make the calls to authorized APIs. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions regarding PostProcessor, JMeter, you can put that in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.